Welcome back to the next generation of the Rent GPU on Golem project. This time, this is the showcase of the oobabooga webUI and Facebook opt-1.3 billion parameters model. This time, we have oobabooga webUI, which is basically automatic 1111 for large language models. And Facebook opt is just a model that is pre-installed on our Golem provider. So at first we will launch the webUI on the Golem via proxy server. Then we will briefly describe the model and its parameters. Then we'll perform inference, which is basically the text generation on the model itself without any LoRA layer applied. After that, we will shortly explain how LoRA works. Then we will train LLM via training LoRA layer. We will load the LoRA layer. And in the end, we will generate text on a model with the LoRA layer applied. So without any further ado, we will go to the RentGPU on Golem website. And we will start a provider SD-3060 with the GeForce RTX 3060 graphics card installed and 13.63 GB of memory RAM available for the provider. We'll click Start and we will click Text WebUI plus Facebook opt-1.3 billion parameters. Our Golem provider is booting up. It will take about 20 to 50 seconds, and I will pause the video and we will see in a moment for you. Okay, welcome back. Our provider has booted up correctly, so we will now head and again to the contents. And right now we will briefly describe the model and its parameters. So we will go and again for the RentGPU on Golem tab with our provider, and we will connect to the text generation webUI via given link. We'll click the link, wait a little bit until our webUI will load. Our webUI is loaded, so we will go to the model section. Inside the model section, we can see Facebook opt-1.3 billion parameters. We can check that this is the only model. It is quite a big model, so we don't want to give too many of those models because, well, the virtual machine will be incredibly large. And we have chosen this model because it is trained on the Facebook posts and comments. So there can be also posts and comments about the medical stuff, but of course, the reliability of those data is questionable. So right now we will try, in this whole showcase, we'll try to pre-train the model, take the pre-trained model and fine-tune it for our purpose. But we will talk about that later. Right now we would like to go for the parameters section. Here is quite a bit of the parameters, which I will not explain right now, because the only parameter that we'll actually need is seed, and we will just write our seed. And seed is the parameter, it is actually the only random parameter inside our generation process, generation of text. Basically speaking, if the input is the same, model is the same, and seed is the same, the output of text generation will be also always the same. So we have been through the model and parameters, so we will head and again for the contents, and we will see that right now we will generate the text on the model itself. So we will go to the next text generation section, and here we can see that our model takes at first some kind of the context of the whole situation in which he is in which he is placed, and we can here write the question. Our question will be hi. Oh, how are you? And we will give a smiley face, and we will ask him to generate the next tokens, the next text. We'll click generate and wait a little bit, and as we can see, he can actually start to talk with himself, and he gives himself some answers because this is how he is trained. Okay, so next, and also that's this is what the parameters we have provided, but we don't care that much because we will use completely different data set. Our data set will be MedQuad data set, which are basically questions and answers for the medical stuff. We will copy the context, which in this case is called instruction. We will paste it. And we will copy the question. We will paste it as well. And we will expect the answer. So we'll click generate and again. And as we can see, we get quite a bit of points in which we can see, of course, according to our model, what are the symptoms of the central core disease. I have no idea what this disease is, but we can read here that this is some kind of the nasty and not too good stuff. But we don't care that much about the contents. We care much more about the we don't care about the because we don't care about the cohesion. Sorry, we don't care about the cohesion with the current medical knowledge, because we right now have a model that is not trained to be really good at the questions related to medical stuff. And as we can see here, we have impairment of the impulse control skills, and here we have impairment of and again impulse control, this time abilities. And our model didn't understand the difference between those two, and he gave those two answers at separate points when he could really easily just make it as a one point. So we will regenerate the text. And what we will expect after our training process is that this answer will be better. It still probably will not be coherent with the current state of the medical knowledge, but at least it will be better. If we will like to make really good, like really, really good model for questions and answers for the medical stuff, then we'll would like to create like really good medical expert, then we'll probably use much bigger model, because right now we use the model that has about 5 gigabytes. So probably I will go with around 200 gigabytes at least. I will provide a lot of different really good medical papers for this model and try to create probably much different way to give data to the model, so we can rate the data, which data is better and on which data our model should put more attention, and on which data he shouldn't learn so much because it's just, you know, one occurrence of the some kind of the state of the body. But we will not talk too much about this. We will talk about our showcase, because it's only a showcase and we will not try to spend too much time on that. So the only thing I would like you is to not approach this as the true medical answer. It's not. It's just the showcase of the technology. So we will go to our data set that we will use for the training process. And right now, what we will do is, sorry, we will regenerate the answer to show you that we will get the same answer and again. Yeah, and as we can see, we have the same answer. We can even copy it and it will be a really good idea. Regenerate and again. And again, we have completely the same answer, as we can clearly see that. Okay, so we will delete those lines. And right now, we will shortly explain how LoRA works. Basically, LoRA is an add-on for one of the more important layers of inference. This layer, those two layers, we can approach as one layer, and those two layers and as the another layer. The bottom one is for attention, so it basically tells the next layer which words are the most important, and the next layer tries to reason about what those words mean and what should he give as the next word in the sequence. So basically, we will try to train this small portion of data that we will store on the GPU. So we will go to the text generation webUI, and right now we will go for the training of our LLM. We will name it New LoRA, and we will choose the data set. We will also choose the format of the data set, and we will start training process. We will get a warning, which we don't care right now about it, but because if we will just load our data in a different way, we could get much better results with the training. It will be just faster, but we don't care that much. We will just start the training process. Everything was loading and was preparing, but right now, as we can see, our training process has started and we have to wait about 50 minutes to finish. So I will not bother you with those 50 minutes of watching changing numbers. We will just see each other in a moment for you and for me in a 50 minutes. So see you in a moment. Okay, so we are back and as we can see, LoRA training is done and also are saved to LoRAs with name new LoRA. So now we will head back to the model section. We will click for LoRAs. There is none of them. We have to refresh. And now we have our new LoRA file. We will choose it and click Apply LoRAs. It took less than a second, and now we have our LoRAs applied successfully. So now what we have done, we have trained LoRA and applied it for the LLM model for the Facebook opt-1.31b. And now by loading LoRA on top of this LLM model, we fine-tuned, pre-trained Facebook OPT model for our special use, which is medical questions and answers. So we will now go for the text generation section. we have copied our previous answer, and we will regenerate exactly the same input. We'll ask for the generation of the text based on the same input and also based on the same seed. So if anything will be changed, it means that model has changed. So now we will click generate and look how our answer will look like. And even now we can see that our answer is more like actual answer and less like a points. We will paste our previous answer, and as we can see, new model is generates answer much more like a conversation and much less like some kind of the computer, I don't know, based on hard logic algorithm, because this is of course also an algorithm, but this is more fuzzy, more human-like answer generated by this new model. So, and again, I would like to remind you that this is not an actual answer, not a good answer. This is just a showcase. If we would like to have real medical expert, real medical recommendations or answers, then we should use really rigorous testing methods, because here we talk about health of the living creatures. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next iteration of the project. Bye.